Healthcare Knowledge Vault. The Knowledge Vault is a property that we have established so that we can share and exchange knowledge across everyone, across industries. Now, before we start, just a few ground rules. While the presentation is in session, I would request everyone to keep their mic on mute. We will have a dedicated question and answer session after the presentation has ended. So in case anybody has any questions that they would like to ask, I request you to please raise your hands on Zoom, and then we will pick you one by one so that you may ask your questions and hopefully we can give you a satisfactory answer. All right. Now, before we start, for those of you who may not be aware, Brown Dove has been in the renal care industry for the past 25 years. We deal in renal care devices from dialyzers to AV fistula needles to blood tubing sets and many more. Now, as you can see on the screen, we are present pan-India across 9 direct offices, more than 70 marketing and sales force, as well as more than 200 dealers and distribution network. We have also in the process of launching our very own digital e-store where, you know, through the convenience of technology, you can directly order our products through our online site. Now, I would like to give a very warm welcome to Mr. Sawar Hussain, who is our guest speaker for today. Now, he joins us with a lot of experience. He is very well known within the clinical sphere. He is the HOD of PSRI Hospital, Pan India. Mr. Hussain, once again, thank you so much for joining
us. Thank you so much, Mr. Nayyar. Shall I start? Yeah.
Okay. Yes, please.
So, as Mr. Nayyar introduced, my name is Sarwar Hussain. I am working in dialysis domain from last 10 years. I am handling PSRI dialysis center, which is have a 24/7 running dialysis center. So I will be talking about middle molecules clearance during dialysis. Guys, so you know this that the three types of molecules we used to see in dialysis. So one of is small molecules, which has the about less than 500 Dalton molecular weight, whereas middle molecules is more than 500 to less than 15,000 Dalton. And the larger molecular weight, the molecules have more than 15,000 Dalton. So for knowing this and what are the merits and demerits of molecules and how to move out this during dialysis, so I will tell you the process of, you know, that in dialysis, we used to see only two things focus, ultrafiltration and a waste product, which is called an adequacy of dialysis. Very the basic way of knowing this, the how is the adequacy of dialysis, only two way. So one is KD by V and URR. So we used to see that how adequate dialysis we are doing. So it is somewhere impact on the patient life, which calls quality of life. If the patient is taking adequate amount of dialysis, at dialysis purify the blood very nicely, so patient can live a happy and healthy life for a long time. Generally, in Indian scenario, people average life is very low in dialysis. Very suppose if I say more than 50% of patient die because of inadequate dialysis, they are not able to get the dialysis. In fact, this is somewhere for us, many dialysis technician also not aware that dialysis only not for removing the ultrafiltration. Somewhere it is also, we have to see the second flip side of the dialysis, which is that how to move out the solutes and what are the advantage and disadvantage of moving out. So, diet of the patient is also somewhere impact on the patient life. And so I'm starting with middle molecules. So the middle molecules, if it is not moving out from the dialysis patient body, so it also somewhere help somewhere impact on the patient body, which also a risk of the cardiovascular disease. And some of the study studies says that it also develop the cancer cells. So for moving out these middle moleculars, we have to use high flux dialyzer. Generally, two types of dialyzers comes in the market, low flux dialyzer and high flux dialyzer. Low flux dialyzer generally comes with the, they can move out from the blood 10,000 Dalton of impurities, whereas high flux dialyzer can move out more than this. So hollow fiber dialyzer, you can see that the low flux dialyzer pore size is average 1 nanometer, whereas high flux is 3 nanometer of high flux dialyzer. So in the studies of Japanese, I have seen in some of the studies, I have just note down, beta 2 microglobulin is one of the middle molecule substance. So the normal range of beta 2 microglobulin in the blood is 0.7 to 1.8 microgram per ml. And the normal size of beta 2 microglobulin in urine is less than 300 microgram per liter, whereas cerebrospinal fluid is 0 to 2.4 milligram per liter. So in Japanese, because I have gone through the Japanese studies, I have just find out. So they use, the government used to reimburse the dialysis fee, amount. So they have categorized this in 5 types. So generally in high flux dialyzer, the normal beta 2 microglobulin clearance rate is 20 ml per minute, whereas low flux dialyzer cannot be efficient enough to move out these molecular molecules, because this low flux dialyzer does not have that level of compatibility as compared to high flux. You know, this Brown Dove also providing a high flux dialyzer. So as a dialysis technician, those are having a high body weight and the patient is not surviving, and we cannot move out all the things from the dialyzer from low flux. Low flux is good, but for those patients, they have beta 2 microglobulin. We should also request from the nephrologist, also advise to the dialysis patient, they should somewhere go to the high flux dialyzer for move out these substance. Middle molecule is a very big challenge for a dialysis patient. In fact, it also adds the cost. This is somewhere demerit, but for we cannot compare everything from the cost. In the some of the studies says in this high flux dialyzer introduced in 1970 for the conservative treatments. In 2006, Japan has introduced 1 to 5 types of dialyzer in high flux. So the category one comes, which is removed less than 10 ml of beta 2 microglobulin or middle molecules ml per minute. Whereas type two is 10 to 30 ml per minute. In the recent study, they have categorized into 2 categories in 2016. So maximum is less than 70 ml per minute of this sieving coefficient, whereas more than 70 ml sieving coefficient also in middle molecules. So you can see on the screen, they have very clearly mentioned. So very, the small molecular weight is urea 60, potassium 35, phosphorus 31, sodium. These are very small molecular weight of substance. Creatinine, phosphorus, all these comes less than 500. So these are small molecular weight substance. In the middle molecules, you can see the above from the 500 and less than 15,000. Vitamin B12 and some of glucose, uric acid, these are for more than 500 molecular weight. And the high molecular weight, you can see the large molecular weight is albumin, myoglobulin, beta 2 microglobulin. Beta 2 microglobulin molecular weight is 11,800 Dalton. So you can see on the screen. So this is what we wanted to pass the message to this forum from my side. So we should counsel the patient. Also, we should sometime patient does not go for the high flux dialyzer. They say that they are feeling weakness after taking the dialysis from the high flux dialyzer. From my side, my opinion, and from my side, I would suggest you to guys just go in deep because we are not telling you very deeply. And just for the simply, I would like to pass the message to all of you. Please counsel the guest, counsel your patients, and you coordinate with the nephrologist and educate your teammates. Importance of high flux versus low flux dialysis and the adequacy of dialysis, how to calculate, how does it impact on the dialysis patient's life. And also the patient diet also play an important role in this. And sometimes patient not take very good diet and they used to go opt for high flux dialysis and they feel weakness. So they think like because of high flux dialysis, we are getting weak. This is because of this, they used to cancel and discontinue the high flux dialysis and they used to go back for low flux dialysis. In some of the studies I have gone through, HDF dialysis, high flux dialysis also, the HDF machine is the one of the best as of now contemporary, removing the middle molecules. It used to clarify 80 to 85% of impurities during dialysis in 4 hours. So this is a study base and Indian study also, many of the Indian nephrology team, ISN, also working on this. But as of now, we used to just give an example from the international studies. Anyway, this is what I wanted to tell you guys.
Thank you, Mr. Sarwar Hussain.
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much for your beautiful narration on this middle molecular clearance. By the way, my name is Swaminathan. I'm heading here as a business head for this product, Dialysis. Can you go to the next slide? Yeah, we have this variety of dialysers in Brown Dove Healthcare Private Limited. In fact, we have steam sterile dialysers which has been recently brought in India from German origin. Polyether sulfone, polysulfone dialysers are available. In fact, Mr. Sarwar Hussain, you have mentioned about the high flux dialysers. We don't have a pick here. We have high flux dialysers also. Right from low flux to high flux dialyzer, including the middle flux dialyzers, we have all the range to serve this patients. And you have nicely explained how this middle molecular clearance is very important in our patients today. And Brown Dove is serving with all these products. And our salespeople will come and talk to you, and we will also email you all these product brochures to you, because this is a session purely on clinical aspects. We are not talking much about the products. Thank you, gentlemen. Any questions you can address to Mr. Sarwar Hussain and he will be answering this. Thank you very much.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen. So as I mentioned earlier, if you could just raise your hand in chat, then we will pick you up one by one so that Mr. Hussain will have enough time to answer your questions sufficiently. Now, anybody with questions, please feel free to raise your hand in chat. Well, if nobody has questions, that means that we were able to answer all of your questions. Somebody with the name Oppo F17 Pro, I believe you had raised your hand for a question. I repeat, Oppo F17 Pro, I believe you had a question. Yes, Oppo F17 Pro, can you hear me now?
Guys, if you have any question, you can just type on this Zoom or message services. We can able to answer your question.
I don't think he's able to hear us. Anybody else with a question, please feel free to go ahead in the chat and we will pick you up. Yes, we have a question here in chat. How many of you in the group are using high flux dialyzers?
I think this question is for all the group, not particularly
yes.
to me.
Yes, yes, yes.
Can I answer this question? If you allow me.
Please, please, please.
Yeah. So, Mr. Kishore, your question is that how many of the people are using this dialyzer? I think if we have dialysis centers across nation, so more than 70 to 80% centers are using, either they are using one for one patient or two patients. But most of the nephrologists, they used to advise, it depends on the patient pocket, and sometimes if they are health conscious enough, they used to opt it based on the nephrologist advice, either they are getting free of cost dialysis also they can opt it. But sometime that people used to avoid only when they have contraindications. But in usual, in general cases, more than 60 to 70% centers are using high flux dialyzer, especially in the metro cities, people, they are using maximum. I'm not talking about rural areas or remote areas. I hope answer the question. Any other questions, please?
So actually, I have a question for Mr. Hussain. Yeah. Now, I was just wondering, what is the importance of removing microglobules in the dialysis process?
Yeah, Mr. Naya, as I already mentioned in my initial talk, so beta 2 microglobulin, if it deposit in the body, so it somewhere evolve the cardiovascular disease. So this is called cardiorenal disease. Okay, and you know that the patient, this well, kidney is our major organ, and another major organ is cardiac heart. So we don't want to take a risk or chance because of depositing of microglobulin in the blood, which also somewhere decrease the quality of life. Also, it also enhance the mortality of dialysis patients. This is that is the reason. So this is, that's why nephrologist advise to move out this beta to microglobulin.
Now I am coming across to you as a layman. So before that, I believe we have somebody has a question. Mr. Rashid, I believe you have a question. Mr. Rashid.
One question.
It's addressed to Mr. Sarwar Hussain.
Yes, Rashid, go ahead.
Mr. Sarwar Hussain.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Swaminathan here. There is one more question asked in the group. Okay. It is generally heard that we need high quality RO water in this high flux dialysis. Is it true? Your opinion on that?
Yeah, sir, my opinion is in general cases, because army guide, we used to follow a standard army guideline, Association for the Advancement of Medical Instrumentation. So we generally suggest the TDS should be 0 to 20, okay, and endotoxin unit should be less than 0.25, and CFU should be less than 50 CFU per ml. So this is the parameters generally we used to follow. High flux, for high flux particulate dialysis, there is no such recommendation to use ultra pure water.
You mean to say that RO water is a must?
RO water is a must with the standard of chemical analysis and microbiological analysis set by the NKF and ISN guideline standard.
There is one more question asked that why is Hyflex not so popular in India, but it is used extensively in many countries?
Yeah, the crunches is because, you know, the people used to see the cost. They do not bother about the consequences. In other countries, the popularity and majority of dialysis used to be borne by the insurance or by the government. You know, we are the developing countries and people are paying from their pocket, and maximum people are from cash panel, not institutional or from the government or insurance side. So now this phenomena will be changed very soon. The insurance company coming in the market, they are providing dialysis services free of cost. Also, government also, they have showing their interest. Ayushman Yojana is one of the best from the government side. So after getting this kind of help from the government and insurance people, they used to definitely look for the good quality of dialysis. And you know the benefits of Hyflex dialyzer, as already I told you. And if anything, the more question will come when you will start using the benefits and some of the consequences you will see. Because in the maximum, you will see in your dialysis center, normally more than 80% we are using Lowflex. So people always choose for the high number of uses. They think that we are getting a good amount of dialysis from this, but this is not good enough for living the healthy and quality of life, from my opinion.
Thank you. There is one more question in the group. You know, since the topic is middle molecular clearance, now we would like to know from you the benefits of inulin, which is also looking like to be a middle molecular clearance during dialysis. What is its significance? Is there any benefits?
Yeah, so middle molecules, not only beta 2 microglobulin, this is particularly one substance. So there are multiple length of, beta 2 microglobulin. You know that if they deposit in the blood, not only inulin or some, I think many things would be there. So if this would not be move out from the body, this will also somewhere develop the some other diseases like cardiovascular disease, mortality rate will increase. Also, some of the disease say this will add for the cancer cell development. So this is somewhere for improving the dialysis patient life, reducing mortality. So we have to opt Hyflex dialyzer for removing middle molecules.
Thank you.
Before we continue, Swami. I believe Mr. Rashid has been trying to ask a question, but I believe he's having technical difficulties. Mr. Rashid, if you could type out your question in the chat, we would be more than happy to read it out for everyone. In the meantime, we can go to the next question, which is, in case of multi-case uses, is there any difference in number of reuses between a low flux and a high flux dialyzer?
Yeah.
So
this is a very good question actually for all of us. So as per ISN guideline, there is no set benchmark for reusing the dialyzer number of use. We have already faced this kind of issue, especially in NABH audit. It's why we are not using this much of time. So there is no such kind of set limits. The fiber bundle volume should be more than 80%. If the fiber bundle volume is more than 80% and dialyzer is completely spick and span, there is no blood and clottings. So we can use as per the hospital and set benchmark of the particular standard. So in the Indian cases, Indian scenario, we are using up to 12 times and there is no problem, particularly from the dialysis adequacy or related to any kind of symptoms. We are not using from the manual process, we are using the dialyzer from automated with the help of machine, and we are using the chemical parasitic acid. No such kind of problem. I don't think so anybody will have difficulty reusing the Hyflex dialyzer. I would suggest people, if they some people are having problem reusing the continuously Hyflex dialyzer, they can opt to dialyzer at one time, like one time low flux dialysis and one time high flux dialysis. So because you know the set benchmark says that if the dialyzer cannot reuse within 7 days, we can again rewash the dialyzer and we can use continuously. Okay, so people, their body is not sustaining high flux dialyzer, but they are having beta 2 microglobulin or middle molecules in their body. So alternatively, they can use high flux and low flux, but this is somewhere typical. Either they can opt the second option, plan B, is that completely 8 to 10 dialysis, they can go for high flux and next time they can use for low flux, and alternatively, they can use, I'm sure they will get benefit and their body, and they will definitely feel from their inside, which is better for their health. This is somewhere improve the hunger, the people, those are facing difficulty, they are not feeling, they are not eating well. So it also improve your digestive eating. Yeah.
Now, before I get on to the next question, I believe some people are having some, facing some kind of technical difficulties. In that case, I would suggest you switch off your video and see if that improves the connectivity. Now, to the next question from Mr. Amit. He says, our unit uses the Fresenius dialyzer. Please highlight the advantage Brontov dialyzer has over the Fresenius dialyzers.
I think you can answer better because this is a brand related problem. The question is something different. It is not a technical question. Actually, the brand value.
Yeah.
You need to tell the cost effect, and I think quality is, I cannot say the which is better and bad. So you should, I think, answer this question.
So I would like to answer this question. Yes, Fresenius dialyzer is a well-established brand. People are using continuously. Now there is a big challenge today in the Indian market. As Mr. Sarwar Hussain said, if you bring a cost-effective dialyzer with a better clearance of middle molecules and also with a polysulfone membrane and with a better biocompatibility, and with steam sterilization, which is also there in Fresenius, we have a microondulation technology, which has been recently introduced in the European market. So when you see as a whole, this biocompatibility, microondulation technique, and also steam sterilization, and cost advantage put together, and ultrafiltration, all the KOA values, definitely our dialyzers are equal or even better than the Fresenius. And only thing is here, we want the people to use the product. Our salespeople are promoting to everybody. Shortly we will establish, because these type of webinars is not for a commercial discussion, but somebody has asked, I would like to answer this. And definitely we will conduct in all the hospitals campaigns and also try to give you the benefits, whatever we have directly to you. Hope it answers your question.
And thank you so much, Mr. Swami. Any more questions, please feel free to type it out in the chat and we will ask it for you. I believe we have a question incoming. One second. Now, I hope all of you are finding this session informative and interesting, because right, this is the whole purpose of this series is to exchange knowledge, to look at what are the latest happenings in the industry, be it from a technical perspective or from, you know, from a knowledge domain. Does somebody with the name iPhone want to ask a question? Okay, one second. I believe we have a question incoming. Yes, how the beta 2 microglobulin is affecting the anemia in a dialysis patient?
Mr. Sagar Hussain.
Yeah, so this question is from Anish. Mr. Anish. Yeah. So anemia is the hemoglobin level from any dialysis patient goes down. So in general cases, from the standard of NCAP, they suggest if the dialysis patient hemoglobin is 9 to 12, this count as a normal hemoglobin. Okay. In this case, the question is that if the patient have beta 2 microglobulin level is high in the body, so does it impact on the dialysis patient, particularly anemia? Yeah, definitely. You know that the health, this is somewhere impact on the dialysis patient body, the hemoglobin level for dialysis patient because of kidney functions, erythropoietin hormone secretion is almost zero. So this is definitely reduce the hemoglobin and the loss of blood in during dialysis. Also, you will see the clotting factors, maybe because of oozing the blood from the patient's axis. So patient hemoglobin will be always in danger. And if this substance toxins are increasing in the body, so giving the injections will not impact very highly as compared to the patient hemodynamically stable instead of unstable condition. Yeah, this is what. Thank you so much.
So in case anybody has any questions, please feel free to ask. If nobody has any questions, then we can conclude today's session of the Knowledge Vault. I'll give you 5 minutes. Any questions, please feel free to type it out in the chat and we will answer them for you.
Sir, mera question hai.
Yes sir,
बताइए बताइए. सर, एक्चुअली मेरे पास दो पेशेंट ऐसे हैं जो होम डायलिसिस डेली होम डायलिसिस हाई फ्लक्स डायलिसिस से करते हैं वो.
मिस्टर विजय, योर वॉइस इज नॉट ऑडिबल, सम कनेक्टिविटी इश्यूज.
यस मिस्टर विजय, if you can hear us, could you type it out on the chat? We are not able to hear you.
More than 69 iron is the possible, and diet intake is the fairly in the no restriction.
Vijay, aapko achhi tarah se sunai nahi de raha hai. Kya aap question chat pe type kar sakte ho kya?
Aapki awaaz saaf nahi aa rahi hai Mr. Vijay, beech mein miss ho rahi
hai. Sir, mere paas
no problem, dobara boliye.
हाँ सर, मेरे पास पेशेंट हैं जो डेली डायलिसिस करते हैं घर पे सर.
नॉक्टर्नल डायलिसिस
जी. तो वो अभी पीछे तो लो फ्लक्स डायलिसिस कर रहे थे लो फ्लक्स डायलाइजर के साथ, अभी जो है वो हाई फ्लक्स के साथ उसको रियूजेबल भी डायलिसिस करते हैं, मतलब कि उसको डायलाइजर को 3 and 4 टाइम उसको रियूज कर लेते हैं. तो उनका कहना यह है कि जब से मैं ये हाई फ्लक्स डायलाइजर यूज कर रहा हूँ डेली डायलिसिस 3.5 hours या 4 hours, तब से उन्हें एरिथ्रोपोइटिन या आयरन की रिक्वायरमेंट नहीं है, खत्म हो गई है उनकी. तो बिकॉज कि उनका डाइट इनटेक इज द नो रिस्ट्रिक्शन, वो सारी चीजें नॉन वेज और फ्रूट्स वगैरह या फ्लूड इनटेक या डाइट जो डेली घर की है वो रूटीन की ले रहे हैं सर. तो सो इज अ पॉसिबल कि नो रिक्वायरमेंट एथ्रोपोटिन और आयरन सीकेडी पेशेंट और मतलब कि जैसे रिक्वायर डेली डायलिसिस पे कर रहे हैं तो.
देखिए मिस्टर विजय, सो लेट मी आंसर द क्वेश्चन. द मोडालिटी ऑफ डायलिसिस यू आर ऑप्टिंग, योर पेशेंट इज ऑप्टिंग फॉर नॉक्टर्नल डायलिसिस. So this is a different kind of modalities, modality of dialysis. You know that there are various kind of modalities in home hemodialysis or HD in dialysis center, peritoneal dialysis. Home hemodialysis always a better option, but nocturnal dialysis is a very best option. The people suggest those are opting home nocturnal dialysis for 6 to 8 hours in 6 days in a week. Only one day they are gapping the dialysis. I know many of the patient, those are taking dialysis because they can remove the dialysis, that ultrafiltration very slow mode, impurities also will get out very slow mode. So dialysis patient, blood pressure, everything will be the normal life because our kidney also work very slowly. They move out, the kidneys move out from the blood, slow ultrafiltration, also waste product ultrafiltration. So patient can have the good appetite and they will eat properly, they will sleep properly. Also, it will also impact on the quality of dialysis. Yes, absolutely. Some of the patient, those are eating well, taking adequate dialysis. In some cases, hemoglobin will maintain for a long term, but some of the time they will require definitely erythropoietin for not for the perpetual purpose. They will definitely require.
Actually, patient का कहना है सर 8 to 10 months से उसने erythropoietin और iron का injection
नहीं होता है. ऐसा होता है. काफी सारे patient हैं क्योंकि they are eating proper diet, पर कहीं ना कहीं उनको sometime if they are surviving and they are sustaining the nocturnal dialysis, that is a very good option. But everyone cannot afford nocturnal dialysis on daily basis.
He is on the Mohammed dialysis.
करते हैं, लेकिन ऐसा होता है. मैं I know many patients, और उसमें कुछ ना कुछ तो ये है कि आप जानते हैं ना कि dialysis का erythropoietin kidney function almost खत्म हो चुके हैं. आपका जो GFR है वो less than आपका 20 या 15 है. ESRD cases में फिर भी उनको erythropoietin तो है नहीं. जो बॉडी के अंदर जो खा रहे हैं एरिथ्रोपोटिन के बिना रेड ब्लड सेल्स नहीं बन सकते. तो उसमें क्या होता है ना कि उनका अच्छा है तो जब तक चल रहा है अच्छा, लेकिन कहीं ना कहीं उनको एरिथ्रोपोटिन की जरूरत तो पड़ेगी. पर ऐसा कितने केसेस में होता है, अगर तो मैं 1 लाख डायलिसिस कर रहे हैं 2 पेशेंट को हुआ, तो उसके बेस पर हम ये तो नहीं सजेस्ट कर सकते ना कि सारे के सारे पेशेंट को एरिथ्रोपोटिन की जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी. अगर जो ऐसा होता तो कोई स्टडी में पब्लिश होता. कुछ है नहीं ऐसा. थैंक यू.
We have one question from Aftab. He would like to know if there are any studies available to project which kind of dialysis is more beneficial, single or reuse, in terms of mortality rates.
Yeah.
And concerned in long term of dialysis.
Okay, Mr. Aftab. Yeah, I'm sure you must have seen the dialyzer wrapper. It is advisable to use single use. Okay. But for cost cutting and for the environment benefit, for reducing the garbage, you know, so we have to opt dialyzer using system. Definitely single use dialyzer is always a better option. For this is also somewhere help to reduce the infection, cross infection, better clearance, or good and adequate dialysis you will get it from single use dialyzer. Thank you so much.
Yes, we will give another 5 more minutes for the question and answer round. So if anybody has any questions, please feel free to ask. I believe Rashid is trying to say something. Mr. Rashid, we cannot hear you. If you can, please type out your question in the chat. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I think we will bring today's session to a close. I hope you found it as informative as I found it. And we will definitely be continuing this platform on a regular basis in the future. And you will continue to receive updates and invites from us as and when the next session is scheduled.
Well, thank you so much, Mr. Sarwar Hussain, for sharing your knowledge. Thank you so much for that. And I would really thank all the participants, and we will be sending you a digital certificate, which you can use on LinkedIn, Facebook, as well as a physical certificate. And please do not forget to like and follow us on LinkedIn and Facebook. We'll be creating a separate private group for all the attendees today, where we can continue to keep in touch and inform you all of all our future activities and webinars.
Okay. Thank you so much, Brown Dove team. I am really thankful to all of you to be a part of this program. I will definitely in touch with you. And for all the forum, those have attended this meeting. This is a really good platform to sharing the knowledge. I would love to be a part of, in near future, your training program. Thank you so much once again, Mr. Anis, Mr. Lokesh, and Mr. Swaminathan. And
thank you so much, Mr. Sarah Hussain, because you given a very good informative message to the team. And I'm thanking all the participants who all are gathered here. I know all are busy with your patients, and for that time being, you you found the timing to us to come and gather and share the knowledge. Share the knowledge which we have shared here. Buddha Sava Hussain, is you have become a part of this meeting. Thank you so much, all the team member who all are participated here. Thank you so much, Sava Hussain, once again. Thank you for the informative message to share. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Sarvar. Thank you, Sarvar.
Thank you very much.
So we are winding up now, right?
Yeah, we are going to
wind
up.
Yeah, so one more thing before we close the session. We will be sending you a feedback form. So if you could kindly fill up the feedback form, share with us your experience for today's session, so that tomorrow we can improve it and make it more entertaining and more beneficial for all of you. On this note, we shall be ending the call. Thank you very much for joining us, everyone. And we look forward to having you in the future as well. Thank you so much, and goodbye.